So Abu Qatada radiyallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever fasts the day of Arafah, Allah Rabbul Izzah forgives the sins of the previous year and the sins of the coming year. So in this are a few benefits. The first is that the sins of 2 years will be forgiven. The one that is passing and the one that is coming, or the one that has passed and the one that is coming. The second point is that if Allah Rabbul Izzah through the tongue of the Prophet takes it upon himself to forgive the sin of the year coming, in it is a hint that if He Azza wa Jal grants you the capacity to fast the day, He will give you the opportunity to live the year and then
Qurbani.
चलो सब ईद मनाए खुशियाँ मिलकर बांट ले एक नबी की उम्मत बनकर सबको गले लगाए हम चलो चले कुर्बान करें हम रब की रज़ा मकसूद हो दीन पे मर मिटने को चले अब तकबीरें ये सुनाए हम अल्लाहु अकबर अल्लाहु अकबर.
We are one ummah. So dear brothers and sisters, honor the person that is next to you. Honor the person that is in your house. Honor the person that you can't see, but that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed great rights upon you in regards to. Let your hearts be connected to them. Let your tongues only speak good about them and to them. And that starts with your family, and then it starts with our community. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite our hearts and unite our ranks here and all over the world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liberate our brothers and sisters in Al-Aqsa in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liberate all of our occupied brothers and sisters. May Allah free all of our brothers and sisters from captivity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uplift our brothers and sisters that are grieving around the world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the fitna away from this community.
इसका निशान है किसी भी कीमत इनकी सुन्नत उम्मत भुला न पाएगी बाप और बेटे किताबेदारी जिंदा रहेगी जान निसारी हशर तलक ये सुन्नत इनकी जिंदा रखी जाएगी.
My brothers and sisters in Islam, today the 11th of Dhul-Hijjah is the first day of Ayyam al-Tashriq. And the days of al-Tashriq, they go on for 3 days, the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th of Dhul-Hijjah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith, he said, أَعْظَمُ الْأَيَّامِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَوْمُ النَّحْرِ ثُمَّ يَوْمُ الْقَرْ. That the greatest days in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the day of al-Nahr, which is the day of Eid, and that was yesterday. That's the best day in the world. And the day that's after, the best day and the greatest day after that day is Yawm al-Qarr. And Yawm al-Qarr is another name for the first day of Ayyam al-Tashriq. Allahu Akbar. So today, literally, is the second greatest day in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the days of the year. Allahu Akbar. So we can comprehend and understand from this and see from this the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how they pour. Now these days, Ayyam al-Tashriq. What does al-Tashriq mean? And then we'll speak about their significance. Al-Tashriq, basically, it's a word used to describe a specific method in how meat would be preserved. So understand this. The Hujjaj, back in the days when they were in Mina, hundreds and hundreds of livestock is being slaughtered, sheep and camel and so on. And all this meat, how is it going to be preserved? They cannot preserve it like we preserve it today. We put it in fridges and freezers and so on. So the way they would preserve meat is in a process known as tashriq. Tashriq basically means drying the meat. So they would take meat and they would slice it into thin layers and they would expose it to the sun, and that meat would dehydrate. It would dry up And as a result, it's now preserved and it can be eaten for many days to come. So that is Ayyam al-Tashriq. That's what al-Tashriq means. This process would be done with the meat. Now, the significance of these 3 days. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith, he said, أيام التشريق أيام أكل وشرب وذكر لله تعالى الله أكبر. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he said that the days of التشريق, these 3 days, are days of أكل, the days of eating, and the شرب, the days of drinking, وذكر لله, and they are days of ذكر of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Now, you know, subhanAllah, incredible hadith, every single day of our life is a day of eating and a day of drinking. So what does it mean that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes these days specifically, saying they are days of eating and drinking? In other words, these are days of in where people should eat and drink a little more than they usually do. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says these are days of eating, meaning eat a little bit more than you do and drink a little bit more than you do. And it also implies that it is haram to fast these 3 days of Ayyam al-Tashriq. So we eat more and we drink more. And obviously this makes sense, because now hundreds and hundreds, if thousands we're speaking about, hundreds and thousands of qurban and sheep are being slaughtered all around the world. So we're supposed to be enjoying this on the Eid, and we're supposed to eat and we're supposed to drink. Now more importantly, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and these are days of dhikri lillahi ta'ala. They're days of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in joyful occasions and happy occasions like Al-Eid. We're never supposed to forget dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the worship of Allah azza wa jal. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described these days in the Quran, he said, وَذْكُرُوا fi ayyamin ma'dudat. He said, and Allah commanded, he said, make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on known specific days. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said that these known specific days are the 3 days of At-Tashriq that we're living in now, 11, 12 and 13 of Dhul-Hijjah. Now something more incredible when observing and looking and pondering into this hadith, al-ulama rahimahumullah, they said that on these 3 days of At-Tashriq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings are completed upon us. Allahu Akbar. How is that so? Because the hadith mentioned eating, drinking and dhikr. And the ulama said that eating and drinking food, this nourishes the body. And dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it nourishes our soul, it nourishes our spirit. And as a result, when your body is nourished with food and drink, and your soul is nourished with dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore Allah azza wa jal's blessings have been completed upon us.